Let's open their tech tree. So in terms of the final tech, quite a nice one to rush for space at least, is to try and get satellites. Because this way when you build, if you manage to build the Hubble Space Telescope, it gives you two great scientists, provides a free spaceship factory in the city it was built. 25% production when building spaceship parts. So if you're going for a space victory, that is the one you want to go for. If you're going for culture, you want to just target the top tree to begin with. Well, you actually, well, you kind of want to, well, you want to try and get to computers and target the top tree, because with the Sydney Opera House, you know, free social policy, 50% culture in the city. So your biggest city, more culture. And also, your National Visitor Center, 100% culture from World Wonders, and tourism just goes straight up again. And then with the internet, doubles the tourism. So the idea is just build this way up to tourism. But if you get to computers and build a great firewall, you'll also protect yourself against other enemy, like, threats. So if someone was actually winning at tourism, you would want to build this to stop them from, or to slow them down from being influential over you, kind of thing. So it's good to try and get that and this if you want to do culture. Science, you kind of want to stick to the middle to begin with, but you do need to actually go up and get particle physics and the nanotechnology. And in terms of war, pretty much the whole bottom. Mobile taxis, but the whole bottom, you get giant death robots and missile cruisers, and obviously your nuclear missiles. So what I want to do though is I want to actually rush towards satellites so I can get the Hubble Space Telescope, and I'll get computers and zoom up the other end. While we're doing that, we will send our little destroyers up this way and join this little battle here. And here we go, three people influential over in 2 turns. Within 2 turns became influential over 3 people. They never saw it coming. Well, so this is America coming to us being like, because they did ask us before, so let's do it. You've declared war. What else are we going to do? I'm going to go back to our options and actually, I think we, the turn movement, so we can actually see some action here. Boom, shoot it. Taking a lot of, some damage, there's a lot of boats in there. Not boats, a lot of bombers in there. Blasted. 53 defense, pretty strong. It is a pretty strong city. Probably do need more if we took our whole navy. If I actually took my great general, great admiral, I should say. Now these bombers might do a bit of damage because there's a few planes even from behind. We'll see. Oh, here come some ships. The planes, they're coming! Nope, here comes another one. At least they're attacking the American one before ours. Waiting for all these to come out though. Oop, there we go. Oop, there's another one. Oop, there's another one. don't know where they went. They're going somewhere, transferring maybe. Because they know their city's going to fall. To the might of the Celtics. Blast the ship to hell. Still survive. Blast it. Go. There we go. Now I survived a gun like that. It's a wooden boat. Surprising. Don't build the airports. Increases the tourism. We're already at 365. We've got a new unit. Another new unit. We make friends with, when you ally with militaristic cities, they do tend to just give you units. Some unique. Like some from different, like, AIs. Or civilizations that aren't even in the game, so. It's pretty cool. Let's see what we got. I suppose once we've done attacking the city. Oh, didn't want to go forward, but. There. You did it already. Stop the city. Now, with destroyers, we get a chance of capturing if we end up destroying it. Now, especially with this one, you can see it's 80% if captured. So go in. And blast that, and we should be able to take this maybe. A high chance, but. There we go, we got it. We got one of their boats. Well, they destroyed their own frigate. It's fair enough, it's up to them. Stadium. Ooh, our battleship is pretty damaged. Let's just heal it. Just like that. Boom. What we can do with this is we can just charge it in and raise the city. We'll raise him. Oh, taking one of their cities. I think it was one of their cities and not like someone else's. Rocketry and have 4 turns from satellites. We've got 3 great engineers sitting ready. I'm gonna do damage. And by damage, I mean we're going to absolutely wreck space. We've got a golden age. Next city in range. Where is it? It is now. That's not our one. We'll get a great admiral up there and do more damage. We'll get him to build the Apollo program. So we can actually build spaceship parts. Where it like signifies the start of the space race. Ooh, they got a battleship. Can I capture it? Not with that one, with this one. 50% chance. Nope, didn't get it. Shit. Hopefully that guy doesn't actually die. Satellites! And now, we're in the information era. And now that we've found everything, or we got satellites, if you look in the map, we can see the whole world. Aha! Those two. We haven't found Villainous Orbis. We can see the whole world and what it looks like. So this is the whole what Denmark's area looks like. It's pretty mountainous. And then Askia was here. In Rome. There's a lot of area that's not been claimed. Korea there. Look at America. You know, kind of claimed that area. Tokyo, so Japan, China was here, and the three cities there. Oh, they lost that one. Okay. Oh, China's gone. Okay. I didn't realize that. Oh, we can't get in because we are blocking that battleship, we're blocking the way in. And we are nearing the end of our game here. And here we go. Now that's the information here. World Congress. And now become the United Nations. So now 6 delegates, 2 per city, and it will alternate between selecting a world leader and whatever we're doing. So already I've got 38 votes, delegates, 8, 6, 6, 6, 12, and delegates to win as world leader is 40, so I'm 2 off. Oh, so I may as well. So I'm pretty much in the firing line for world leader as well. So space, tourism, world leader, we're all set for everything. I used that guy again. Didn't mean to. Not paying attention. I'm surprised from being allied with Yerevan, I hadn't like seen a ship or something. It's just fantastic. Well, what we're gonna have to do is to grab maybe a destroyer and we'll send him round. We'll send you out. Boom. Boop. If it was owned by someone else, it would say liberate, but it doesn't, so we'll just raise. And there you go, we've done the Apollo program. Give ourselves an extra range so we can now shoot further inland with that XP. Ooh, how do you survive that? Do the same here. We can now shoot the city from here, 3 tiles away. Seems pretty insane. Oh, here we go. We're gonna get Hubble next turn. Try and make sure we're still allied with everyone. Like Ruza. That's probably. We probably now have enough, don't we? Maybe. We'll see. We will see. The Hubble Space Telescope. So it's giving us a space factory. A space factory. It's giving us a, like a launch pad. As you can see there. I suppose it is a space factory. We actually have a look at our city. Unemployed citizen. There we go. Should be back in. Space Porter is something it was called. All the buildings we built, they're all the time. That's probably there somewhere. But you know what? We are going to build the first piece, and what we can do is just rush that piece. And these great scientists, we can just rush them as well. I think Korea's entered the atomic era. Oh, see, they captured their city back, that's why I went out of it. Each time a city gets captured, its population gets lowered or halved each time. So it's pretty handy if you just want to jump back and forth. Yeah, it is a spaceship factory, okay. I was right. Right, what we're going to do is... Actually, let's go to advanced ballistics. Seeing how we're at war, let's just... Let's just make things a bit more fun. And drop a nuke. I say, because that's a fun thing to do. It's an awful thing to do, but you know, it is what it is. Great firewall. We with that, we've negated all foreign, like, tourism against us. Let's look at our tourism output. Korea's got 0. Denmark's got 16. 44. America's 17. No one has this against us. We're about halfway, maybe. Rome. We're getting a year even quicker. It's the Pentagon. We can build the Pentagon. Halves upgrading the price cost of upgrading units. Got all these great generals everywhere. Let's just shoot them. Shoot them down. This great admiral, just snip that up. We got America here with all the aircraft carriers. Be nice if they just went that way, you know. Well, that'd give me a city, actually. You know what? Sure. This city, okay. Well, I've just raised it, so... you have no need for it. I see what's happening on the other side, I didn't realise. I think Rome has wanted to make peace because Mr. Bluetooth has just come straight. Just wrecked him on this end. I wasn't aware. No, nearly. Well, actually, I wonder. We're at 38 still. I wonder if it updates maybe next turn. Or if I do need to, like, get villainous in order to get the extra 2 points. We got a bazooka. Pretty much what your archers turn into. Ooh, we are down, so we don't actually have enough. But you know what I will do? I will embargo them. Even then, it's not the actual world leader. I think after this vote, it will be. Now we can make ballistic missiles. The booster engines. Had a great engineer there. Let me just rush that. In terms of tech, let's just send it all the way up here. We're pretty much like winning on every front, so it's not too bad. I would say probably wouldn't be winning as much if we didn't go rationalism. As soon as you hit rationalism, like I said, it just skyrockets. Because we were... we're up at thousands. It's crazy. It's just how it is. Oh. Add another bit to our spaceship. And another one. We go here, we can't actually... we can build another one, but we don't have a spaceship, like, port area. So it'll be more expensive. Now he wants to be friends because he's... just got wrecked. America and Japan are at war now. America just seems to be causing a lot of war between these two people. Or Congress. Well, I think I know who I'm going for. You tried to stop me. You could not. Oh, they took Tokyo in one turn. Oh my god. It's crazy. Well, we have 40 people. We can indeed... I say 40 people, we've got 40 delegates. We can vote me as world leader and I will rule overall. That being said, you know, there's many ways I could have won. I could have taken a complete U-turn and just completely annihilated everyone at that point. If I really focused on it. Here we go. Diplomatic victory.
But also looking at it, it was also science,
tourism,
which was an all-round victory.
Soldiers. I mean, we didn't even finish the tech tree. There's still so much to do. But in terms of population, you know, pretty good population. Look at the ranking. Third in terms of the score. Look at replay, actually. Kind of shows you all the messages. It's pretty crazy. The graphs. Score. Who's that? I was asking. Yeah, they just got wiped out. In China. Let's have a look at population. Oh, Siom's population is pretty good. Where's... Huh. It's dipped after his city got taken, like, but I thought mine would have been pretty decent. We're total culture. Oh, you see me with my golden ages. The spikes are all the golden ages there. Yep. And then we also got the map. So we see we... So that's Rome, Korea. We spawned there. So though we won diplomatically, we could have won many other ways. So overall this game was pretty good. It did, in terms of gameplay, may have been lackluster, we're just saying currently. A couple, especially at the start, it was a bit more entertaining, but you know, just how it goes. Who knows, maybe next time we might play a game where it's a bit more lively. It might not be so peaceful.